Good morning, students. Myself Renu Yadav, and today I will teach you the human body, class 3rd, science, chapter 2, part 2. In this part, we will discuss about the respiratory system. First of all, what is respiratory system? The respiratory system is the network of organs and tissues that help you breathe. It includes your airways, lungs, and blood vessels. The muscles that power your lungs are also part of the respiratory system. These parts work together to move oxygen throughout the body and clean out waste gases like carbon dioxide. The organs that help us to breathe form our respiratory system. The organs of the respiratory system are nose, windpipe, and lungs. In the diagram also, you can see children, in the diagram of the respiratory system, the organs are given. The organs of respiratory system are, the first one is ears, nose, second is windpipe, and the third one is lung. Now let us see how these different parts help us to respire. The first part is nose. We take in air through our nose. Okay, children, you can feel also whenever you are breathing, you are taking the air in with the help of your nose. And the air is divided into two parts. The first one is inhaled air and the other one is exhaled air. What is inhaled air? The air we breathe in. Okay. The air which we are breathing in is the inhaled air. That means this air is rich in oxygen. Yes, because we need oxygen. Okay, so the inhaled air is the air that we breathe in, and the inhaled air is rich in oxygen. Now the second type is exhaled air. Exhaled air is the air which we breathe out of our body. Okay, the air which we breathe out is the exhaled air, and that means this air is rich in carbon dioxide. Okay, what is exhaled air? The air which we breathe out of our body is exhaled air. Therefore, exhaled air is rich in carbon dioxide. Inhaled air is rich in oxygen. Exhaled air is rich in carbon dioxide. Inhaled air is the air which we breathe in, and exhaled air is the air which we breathe out. The process of respiration. The hair present inside the nose trap the dust particles. From the nose, air goes to the windpipe. From the windpipe, air goes to the lungs. The air we breathe in is rich in oxygen. Blood absorbs oxygen from the lungs and brings back carbon dioxide from the body cells to the lungs. We breathe out this carbon dioxide through our nose. Children, During breathing, we take air in to our lungs through the nose. And in the nose, hairs are present which used to trap the dust particles present in the air. Then the nose will give the air, will pass the air to the windpipe. Okay, this is we have started with inhalation. Okay, we have inhaled air and then the nose will pass the air to the windpipe, and from the windpipe the air will move towards the lungs. And the air which we are inhaling, it is rich in oxygen. Okay, and then the blood absorb all the oxygen from the lungs and give the carbon dioxide from the body cells to the lungs. The oxygen is absorbed and carbon dioxide is given to the lungs. And when we breathe out, carbon dioxide rich air through our nose. And this last process is exhalation. Therefore, a breath means one inhalation plus one exhalation. Through this flowchart also, we can understand the passage of oxygen and carbon dioxide in our body. We start with inhalation, where the oxygen passes from the nose to the lungs, to the blood, and then to the heart. And then the heart divides the oxygen to the whole body. And carbon dioxide is exhaled out from the body parts, moving towards the blood, to the heart, and then finally to the lungs. And then lungs exhale the carbon dioxide outside of the body. What is breathing? The taking in and giving out of air is called breathing. We can say that breathing is the process of moving air out and in the lungs to facilitate gas exchange with the internal environment, mostly to flush out carbon dioxide and to bring in oxygen. Okay, we breathe to bring in oxygen and to flush out or to give out carbon dioxide from our body. There are few things which we should follow to have a good respiratory system. We should always breathe through our nose. It is because if we will breathe through our nose, the hairs which are present in the nose, they will act as a filter and prevent the dust particles which are present in the air to enter into our respiratory system. Second, never cover your face with a sheet while sleeping. You should never cover your face while sleeping. And go to a park or a garden and do deep breathing exercises in the morning. You should always go to a park or garden, like the places which are rich with trees. There are a lot of greenery there. Okay, there you should go and you should do deep breathing exercises. It will help you to get more and more of oxygen. With this, I end up today's topic. Thank you.